here's the thing I want you guys to recognize is right now, this is the time. I mean, it's time right now to step it up, and it's time right now to say, hey, look, you know what? This is it. This is my chance to do something special. Right now, this is my time to do something great. I'm going to step up, and I'm going to become that great leader. I'm going to go out there, and I'm going to impact people's lives. I'm going to go out there, and I'm going to change people's lives. And I'm going to go out there, and I'm going to get more committed than ever before. And I'm going to be that type of person that people want to follow. More importantly, I'm going to be that person that's going to make me feel good about who I am. And I'm going to go out there and give it my absolute very best. So today we're going to train real quickly on the law of respect. Right now, you guys, when you look at the law of respect, you know, what is it all about? How do you gain that level of respect? How do you gain, you know, that level of you know, respect where people say, hey, look, you know what? I want to step up. I want to make it happen. I want to go all out. And today we're going to be covering exactly what it takes for you to be able to get the law of respect under your belt so you can go out there and really lead people. Because when a group of people come together right now, you want to realize that, guess what? You know, people are going to follow the people that are going to be the strongest leaders. So how do you become that strong leader? That's today what we're going to train on. And I want you to capture this information. And then we're going to get a chance to learn about the law of magnetism. And once you wrap your head around the law of magnetism, you're going to get fired up, because you're going to realize now that, guess what? That, you know what? I can go out there and really make an impact. So I'm going to dive into this information. This is the law of respect. Now, what does the law of respect say? And we've got some very good information on this, and we're going to get a chance to watch the law of intuition. So people naturally follow leaders who are strong in themselves, as you know. If people do not have trust in you as a leader, they will not respect you nor want to follow you. Okay, so keep that in mind. Also keep in mind, this is the prime example. Harriet Tubman, she was one of the greatest leaders, risk taker. People respected her. And basically in 1850, she made her first trip basically as the conductor of the Underground Railroad. And people, if they got caught, would be killed. And so would she. And she never allowed people that she was leading to give up. This is powerful. Anytime people would follow her, she would never let them give up. And what she would say is this: dead folks tell no tale. Dead folks tell no tales. Okay, and she would put basically a loaded pistol next to their head. Wow. Do you understand? So basically, whenever she's leading people throughout the Underground Railroad, saving people, and they you know, she was like the Moses of that time, leading people out. When they would get all afraid, she just put a gun to their head and simply say, look, dead folks tell no tales. So you kind of inject a little bit of confidence into them. Do you guys see that? We call that fear of loss motivation, right? But she was like greatest leader of all time, right? So obviously, you've got to have that type of backbone. Do not, though, please, whenever you're trying to help somebody get their 8 points to qualify for this, don't put a gun to their head. Okay? Anymore. I'm just kidding. Don't do that again, okay? Law of respect, 6 ways that a leader gains respect of others. Number 1, natural leadership ability. Right, remember last week, John C. Maxwell talked about natural inclinations, talked about leadership. Some people are naturally leadership inclined. Sometimes, guess what? You just have that natural leadership ability, okay? If you possess it, people will want to follow you, okay? They will become excited when you communicate your vision. So some people just naturally have that leadership ability. That's wonderful, okay? They naturally have that influence. Now, guess what? If you don't have that natural ability, doesn't make a difference. Why? Because you can learn leadership skills. You can learn leadership ability. Leadership ability is easy. It's not really easy to learn, but it's worth it to learn. Number 2 is respect for others. For your notes. Okay, when a leader shows respect for others, especially for people who have less power or less position than theirs, they gain respect from others. Okay, if you continually respect others and consistently lead them well, you will continue to have followers. So you got to obviously respect other people, appreciate other people. You know, be really thankful for the people right now that, guess what, are counting on you to get them to the top. You got to make sure that you deliver the goods and get them to where they want to go. Law number, part number 3 of this is very simple. Courage. Okay, good leaders do what's right even at the risk of failure. Okay, in the face of great danger and under blunt, relentless criticism, can you think of one great leader in history? Okay, in the entire history, okay, who was without courage? A leader's courage gives his followers hope. You got to have that courage no matter what. when you're up against obstacles. Guess what? And you're up against challenges. And guess what? You got to stay up a little bit later. You got to wake up a little bit earlier, and you got to give a little bit more. When you have that courage and you have that backbone, guess what? Like what Billy Graham said. He said what? Right? When a leader, you know, stiffens his backbone, the backbone of other people gets stiffened as well. So when you have that courage, guess what? That courage gets transferred to other people. Another one, very powerful, I think you'll agree with, is success. When leaders succeed in leading the team to victory, the followers believe they can do it again, okay? As a result, followers follow them because they want to be a part of the success in the future. So guess what? When you do well and you make it happen and you force results and you have, you know, how people become successful, people say, hey, look, you know what? I want to be a part of that too. I want to be a part of your team because everybody that's following you is getting to the top. Number five, I think you guys will really appreciate this one, right, is loyalty. When leaders stick with their team until the job is done and look out for their followers' best interests, even when it hurts them personally, followers will turn. Will in turn learn to respect them. So the key is guess what? Be loyal to your people, right? Don't give up on them, man. Sometimes you're working with people, and guess what? They don't get it, right? You know what? Don't give up on your people. Care about your people, man, and believe in your people. Believe in the people that that are following you. Believe in them and let them know, guess what? You know what? You can make it happen, okay? That you can become a success. Next one is this, value, okay? I like this one. Value added to others. Followers value leaders who add value to them, and their respect for them carries on long after the relationship is ended. That's the deal, man. When you go out there and just add value to others, that's the deal, man, because you change them. That's my favorite thing to do, is to add value to people's lives. I just love it. I love that the fact that, guess what? You go out there and you touch someone's life and you make them better, and they don't, once you've gone better, you don't go back. You see what I'm saying? So once you grow people, man, it's like the greatest reward in the world. Pour your life into growing people. How do you do that? Pour your life into growing yourself. See how it works? It's kind of a no-brainer. Now watch. This is what I want you to know. That's it, Dean Smith. No, but Michael Jordan, right, it's funny, I was actually, I drove right by Chapel Hill on Tuesday. I was out in Carolina, and at North Carolina, Dean Hill was like the deal. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody loves this guy. But basically, in 1993, before a playoff game in Chicago, Michael Jordan's dad, James Jordan, had credited Dean Smith for the leadership of a lot of his son's success. So his elder son observed, okay? This is what James Jordan, Michael's father, said. People underestimate the program that Smith runs. He helped Michael realize his athletic ability and honed it, okay? But more importantly than that, he built character in Michael that he took with him through his entire career. I don't think Michael was privileged to any more of his teachings than anyone else. He had a personality to go along with the teachings. That's the only way I can look at it. And I think that's what made Michael the player that he became. Wow. That's his dad. His dad saying that about his son, that it was Dean Smith who made the difference. You know what I mean? So the people that are closest to Smith respect him the most. That's what's magical. Dean Smith's a beast. Watch how this works. Here's what it looks like. At the beginning, leadership, whenever people come together, everybody's kind of going their own direction, right? And then what happens is basically, once you decide, hey, look, you know what? Boom, I'm gonna make it happen, people start kind of following. And then as the direction changes, then everybody kind of lines up. So whenever you're building your organization, sometimes you might find out that, guess what, people aren't really following. You just got to develop your leadership skills and find out, guess what, people are going to follow you because you've developed those leadership skills. Another good example of this would be what? John Wooden. A lot of you know Bill Walton. Bill Walton was a grizzly bear, right? I mean, Bill Walton was a beast, okay? And obviously, you guys all know, Hall of Famer, right? But when Bill Walton joined the UCLA Bruins in the early 1970s, he wore, okay? Coach Wooden said, no one can have a beard. It's pretty straightforward, right? So Bill Walton said, look, I'm not going to shave it. He refused to shave his beard. And Coach Wooden's his no-nonsense response was, we're going to miss you, Bill. Do you guys see? It wasn't going to say, okay, well, guess what? I'm going to change the way that I operate because guess what? I'm going to let the tail wag the dog. He didn't let the tail wag the dog. He stepped up and told him, hey, see you later, buddy. And then all of a sudden, bam, there's Bill Walton looking a little bit different. Do you guys see the difference? Right, see anything? What about that picture? What's he missing? His beard. Yeah, so we want to scoop that thing off. So obviously, that's what it's about. Obviously, Clint Eastwood said this. I love this one. Respect your efforts. Respect yourself. Self-respect leads to self-discipline. When you have both firmly under your belt, that's real power.